Check out FlipsideGaming.com for all your gaming needs. Use the promo code HEROES to save 10% on all orders over $10. Hey there, this is John from Heroes and Legends, and today we have a big news day for Magic the Gathering. We're going to be talking about the banned and restricted list update first and foremost. Then we're going to move on to the Star City Games Invitational, look at some of those Pioneer and Modern deck lists, and I know a lot of people especially will be interested in those Pioneer deck lists because this is the first time we've seen that format on a big stage like this one. Quickly though, before we get started, just a fast reminder, like you saw at the top of the video, if you use that Heroes promo code at FlipsideGaming.com, you can save yourself a little cash. It also supports the channel, which is always appreciated, so thank you. And without any further ado, let's get into it. We'll begin with the banned and restricted list update, starting with the standard update. Okay, first card that was banned, probably no surprise, we saw this one coming. Oko, Thief of Crowns, has been officially banned in standard. Also banned, though, Once Upon a Time, as well as a third card, Vow of Summer. Okay, so Wizards went ahead and explained this banning, although I think for the most part, if you've been following the format, you kind of know why. Green has been a very dominant color. They didn't feel like banning Oko was going to be enough, so they hit these other two cards as well, and they're just trying to bring more diversity to the format. I mean, we talked a lot about how Oko has been everywhere. 69% at Mythic Championship number 6 just a week ago. That is staggering how many people were playing that card in such a high-level event. So these changes will go into effect officially on November 22nd when it comes to Paper Magic, but they will go into effect today on Magic the Gathering Online as well as Arena. Also, too, in case you're keeping track, the next banned and restricted list update is December 16th. But before we move on to the Star City Games Invitational, there is more to talk about here. Brawl update. Now, they actually made this announcement a number of days ago, and we have discussed it on the channel already, but they did officially add this to the list. Oko, Thief of Crowns, banned in Brawl. Legacy also had an update this weekend. Renin 6 has been banned. Now, what they said about this one is Temur Delver variants, which run this card, have been very dominant in the format. Right now, their win percentage rate is about 56.6%, which is very high. So they went ahead and banned this card, trying to even things out there. Vintage got an update too. Narset, Parter of Veils has been restricted. One of the things with Vintage, they do try to make an environment where you can play all your crazy old broken cards. Narset shut a lot of decks down very early and kind of soft locked you because drawing cards is just such a big part of Vintage. So if this hit the table like on turn one, there were a lot of decks that didn't have good answers to that. So they're trying to open up the format a little bit by restricting this down to one per deck. Okay, if you're wondering about Pioneer, that update is going to occur later this afternoon. So by the time you see this video, maybe it will be out, I don't know. But it will be much later in the day from the time of recording. Now, with that being said, we'll cover that tomorrow on the channel, assuming there are any changes. Okay, on to the results of the Star City Games Invitational. This is kind of like their version of the Pro Tour for the Star City Games circuit. So remember, this is not just the Pioneer tournament. These players were using Pioneer as well as Modern decks. We're going to look at the two top eights, but keep in mind, a good Modern deck could have propped up a weaker Pioneer deck or vice versa when it comes to actual results here. Here's what your top eight players were playing when it comes to Pioneer. First place, Mono Black Aggro. Second as well as third place, Mono Green Devotion. Fourth place, Gruul Aggro. Fifth place, Hardened Scales. Sixth place, Golgari Delirium. Seventh place, Isn't in Soul. And eighth place, Bant Ramp. We're going to go ahead and take a look at some of these deck lists with a special focus on cards that come from Throne of Eldraine. Here's your first place Mono Black Aggro deck. This build has been pretty successful over the last couple weeks, and it put up a great result here, obviously. Now, a lot of folks may be looking at these deck lists for the first time when it comes to Pioneer, so I'll try to go at least slow enough for you to take in the deck list, but at the same time, feel free to pause the video if you need to. You will see some elements here from classic aggressive decks like Scrap Heap Scrounger, Smuggler's Copter, four copies of each of those. You also get four copies of Fatal Push, four copies of Thoughtseize, that's worth noting, all here in the main. There's some interesting tech in here too, like four copies of Night Market Lookout. Let's go ahead though and look at the cards from Throne of Eldraine that are here. In the main, you find Murderous Rider, Rankle, Master of Pranks, and Castle Lock Thwain. Okay, here's the second place Mono Green Devotion deck, and Mono Green Devotion has been very, very strong so far in the format. So strong, as a matter of fact, that it has taken a number of bannings. Leyline of Abundance, Oath of Nyssa, Veil of Summer, they've already been banned in the format. Even so, though, the deck is still very strong. Let's take a look at it. You're going to find a lot of Mana Dork, Selvish Mystic, Llanowar Elves are here. A lot of classic cards that have been strong in the past too. Things like Scavenging Ooze, Jadelight Rangers are in here. walking ballistas, four of those in the main. And when it comes to planeswalkers, four copies of Nissa Who Shakes the World and four copies of Vivian Arcbow Ranger. Let's go ahead and take a look at the cards, though, from Throne of Eldraine that are here. Once Upon a Time in Castle Garenbrig in the main. And in the sideboard is Questing Beast. Very popular card right now in Pioneer. You're going to see a lot of it as we go through some of the deck lists today. Here's the fourth place Gruul aggro deck, and you do see a few similarities. Obviously, those mana dorks are all here again, Elvish Mystic and Llanowar Elves. But this is doing some different things, as you can see. Four copies of Legion Warboss, four copies of Goblin Rabble Master, two Gore Clan Rampager. Let's go ahead and take a look at the cards from Throne of Eldraine, though. Four cards in the main, Lovestruck Beast, Questing Beast, Once Upon a Time, and Embercleave. Fifth place, we saw Hardened Scales. This is a take on the Modern deck, which has been, of course, very good over the years. And as you can see here, there's some components that are very similar. There's two copies of Hangerback Walker in the main, four copies of Walking Ballista, four Hardened Scales in the main, obviously, when it comes to Planeswalkers, four Nissa Voice of Zendikar, one Vivian Arcbow Ranger. And here's what Throne of Eldraine brings us in the main, Stonecoil Serpent, Once Upon a Time, and in the sideboard, Questing Beast. Golgari Delirium came in sixth place. This is a deck that a lot of people thought would be good right out of the gate, and yeah, it is. It took some time for people to figure out the build, though, and it's beginning to solidify now into what we're looking at here. So a few of the key cards that I just wanted to point out quickly. Grimflyer, four of those, very obvious inclusion here. And we've seen decks like this in Standard in the past. There's a lot of the same cards. In addition, there's two copies of Tireless Tracker here in the main. Kalidas Trader Gat, a copy of that card is in the main. Noxious Gearhulk even makes it in here. One Walking Ballista. As for Planeswalkers, two copies of Liliana the Last Hope, two copies of Rask of Golgari Queen, and in the sideboard, notice there's even a copy of Liliana Death's Majesty. From Throne of Eldraine in the main is Murderous Rider, Castle Lock Thwaine, and Fabled Passage. In the sideboard again is Questing Beast. Seventh place was Isn't in Soul, and if you remember back in Standard when In Soul Artifact was legal there, we did have a deck that was doing some similar things, but when you look at the deck list overall, this is pretty different. A couple of the key components, though, that have not changed are things like the four In Soul artifacts in the main, as well as four copies of Darksteel Citadel. But if you look a little deeper, you're going to find a number of cards from Throne of Eldraine, which we're going to look at in a second, but also things like Wild Slash, Shrapnel Blast is in here, Metallic Rebuke, Skilled Animator is even in here, four copies in the main. Throne of Eldraine, though, brings us Ginger Brute and Stonecoil Serpent, perfect for this deck. And in the sideboard, you're going to find Mystical Dispute. Eighth place is Bant Ramp, but you might call this a Bant Field of the Dead deck, actually. There are four copies of that card here in the main, and a whole lot of different lands to just make that more potent. But on top of that, there's other things going on here, too. Three copies of Oko Thief of Crowns is one of the big things you'll notice. Teferi Time Raveler, one copy in the main, two in the sideboard, one copy of Ugin the Spirit Dragon in the main, too. When it comes to Throne of Eldraine in the main, Oko we've already mentioned, but you can also find Castle Vantress and Fabled Passage. Glass Casket is in the sideboard. We'll go beyond the top 8 and look at the 11th place Simic Aggro deck since we haven't seen one of these decks yet. Early on in the tournament, like day 1, this deck was performing very, very well. Still put up a very good result by the end, too, as you can see here. One of the strategies here is you have Lovestruck Beast, which of course is better with 1-1 creatures. You have Elvish Mystic, you have Llanowar Elves. A lot of ways to ramp, obviously, but then you have Oko Thief of Crown, so you can turn those mana dorks into 3-3 Elks when you just want to put pressure on. Wouldn't be shocked if one of these cards in here gets banned, maybe even today, if not down the road. But right now, this is a very solid build. A lot of cards from Throne of Eldraine. I mentioned Oko and I mentioned Lovestruck Beast, but you also get Brazen Borrower, Questing Beast, Yorvo, Lord of Garenbrig, and Once Upon a Time. In the sideboard is one more copy of Questing Beast. Some other variations of this decklist that performed well this weekend also will have Gilded Goose in the main. Here's the 16th place Sultai midrange deck. This is another deck that runs Oko. We'll look at that card again in just a second. Three copies in the main. You also have things like Tireless Tracker, two Jace Vryn's Prodigy in this build, two copies Kalidas Trader of Gat. There's a Tassigur in here, two Liliana the Last Hope. Throne of Eldraine cards in the main. Like I mentioned, there's Oko and also Fabled Passage. In the sideboard, again, Questing Beast. All right, let's move on to the modern portion, and we won't look at all the modern decks. I just want to focus on the ones that are using cards from Throne of Eldraine, because some of these deck lists really haven't changed that much. The first place deck was Humans. We're actually not going to look at that one because there's no Throne of Eldraine cards, not even Charming Prince this time. Kind of curious to see if Charming Prince will start dropping out of other builds of that deck. Second place was Mono Green Tron, and not running Once Upon a Time this week. We'll have to see if maybe that's starting to fade out too. Third place, though, was Grixis Death Shadow. That also came in seventh place. We will look at that deck list. Fourth place, Amulet Titan. Fifth place, Eldrazi Tron. That one was not running any cards from Throne of Eldraine. Sixth place, Simic Urza. And eighth place was Crabvine. Here's the third place Grixis Death Shadow build. Arguably one of the more powerful decks right now in Modern. It did come in third place, not first or second, but there still were a number of copies other than this one in the top 16. So let's go ahead and take a look at what's going on here. The deck hasn't changed much. Death Shadow, of course, being a key part of it. Snapcaster Mages are here. Gurmag Angler. Let's look at the cards from Throne of Eldraine that are showing up. The Royal Scions in the main. And another copy in the sideboard, as well as Mystical Dispute. Other variations of this deck that performed well also run Drown in the Lock, sometimes in the main, but also sometimes in the sideboard. Amulet Titan came in 4th place, another one of the more powerful decks recently, and this did get a boost from Throne of Eldraine, we'll look at it in just a second, but Once Upon a Time has been a pretty key card here. Now, aside from that, you know what this deck does. 4 copies of Primeval Titan, 1 Reclamation Sage here in the main, 4 copies of Sakura Tribe Scout, 4 Azusa Lost But Seeking, obviously 4 Amulet of Vigor, and here's the cards for Throne of Eldraine. I mentioned Once Upon a Time, Castle Garenbrig also here though, and seeing a lot of play in these builds. Mystical Dispute in the sideboard. Simic Urza came in 6th place. So the Simic Urza variety of this deck has taken off a little bit because it can play Oko, in this case 4 copies in the main. A lot of people were speculating that other variations of this deck would rise to the top, but of course Oko kind of threw a wrench in that, and even though those other variations can still perform very well, this one seems to keep rising to the top in the big events. If you're not familiar with this deck, it runs Zemri, Lurker of the Lock, Urza Lord High Artificer, 4 copies of each in the main, 4 copies of Mox Opal, this one not running any Mox Ambers, which is pretty typical. Sometimes they'll run one copy of that card here or there, but for the most part, they just go heavy on Mox Opal. You also have 4 copies of Arkham's Astrolabe here, 3 copies of Karn the Great Creator in the main. And here are the cards from Throne of Eldraine. So we mentioned Oko and Emery already. Gilded Goose is here too, as well as Mystic Sanctuary. This deck wasn't doing it, but sometimes you'll find Drown in the Lock in the sideboards of these builds. Crabvine came in 8th place. This is a deck that's been doing pretty well recently too. Very reminiscent of one of the decks that we saw back in the day when Hogak was still around, actually. So this is kind of a variation on that build without Hogak, but it's still very good. 4 copies of Vegvine, 4 copies of Merfolk Secret Keeper. Of course, that's a new card we'll look at in just a second. 4 copies of Gravecrawler are here, 4 Hedron Crab, 3 copies of Glimpse the Unthinkable in the main, 4 copies of Creeping Chill. Here's the 2 Throne of Eldraine cards you find in the main deck, Merfolk Secret Keeper, like we mentioned, and Once Upon a Time. Okay, we'll move beyond the top 8 with the 11th place Infect deck. One of the things you'll notice right off the bat with Infect is it's running Oko, Thief of Crowns, usually out of the sideboard, though. So we'll see that card again in just a second, but other than that, you kind of know what this is all about. 4 Blighted Agent, 4 Glistener Elf, 3 Groundswell, 4 Might of Old Krosa, even 3 copies of Scale Up here. Once Upon a Time is in the main from Throne of Eldraine. And in the sideboard, we mentioned Oko, but also Mystical Dispute. Devoted Devastation came in 16th place, and you guessed it, Oko is here too. 2 copies in the main, 1 copy in the sideboard. Teferi Time Raveler, the other Planeswalker you'll find here, 2 in the main, 1 in the sideboard. And aside from that, yeah, Devoted Devastation is doing what Devoted Devastation does. These decks use Devoted Druid, 4 copies here, 3 copies of Vizier of Remedies to go alongside it, 4 copies of Finale of Devastation in the main as well. And like we mentioned, there's Oko and Once Upon a Time also here in the main, and the extra copy of Oko in the sideboard. That wraps up today's update. Like I mentioned earlier, there's going to be a change later today when it comes to the Pioneer format, perhaps. They will be updating the ban list there. And we will bring that news to you at the latest early tomorrow, so stay tuned. Might even be out by the time you watch this video, actually. But until next time, hey, thanks for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe, and have a great day. Hey, thanks for watching. This video is made possible through the generous support of viewers like you on Patreon. Check out the description below for links to our Patreon page, as well as our Amazon affiliate store, where a small percentage of all sales will also help support the channel. Finally, if you haven't had a chance yet to subscribe, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of the new videos on Heroes and Legends. Talk to you again soon, and have a great day.